So in normally in object oriented programming, there is a function overloading concept, but in Python there is no function overloading concept. Means you cannot have two functions with the same name. Normally it is called as function overloading, but if you want to build the constructor, normally we will be having several constructors, but since Python does not allow the overloading, so this we can take help of default arguments, some logic, and one more concept called class methods to overcome this problem. So here what I'll do is I'll have a constructor with parameters. Like I'll take length as one parameter, then width as one parameter, height as another parameter. So I'll remove this message because it's just to indicate that constructor is called. I'm keeping it. So I'll say here L W H, and I'll print the same thing. Display I'll print as it is. Now when I call this objects now. So here I'll be building the object of the class. I'm creating instance. So box one, new, box. I'll pass some parameters, 10, 7, 3. 10, 7, 3. So box object is created. Then I'll call the display method. So I'll execute this. I'll increase the size. Maybe it may not be. So here I'm setting 1073, and it is called, suppose if I say 12, 9, 5, so whatever you pass that, based on that it is called. Now suppose if I want to create a box with the same size, suppose box 2 equals to box, I want to set 10, 10, 10. Box 2 dot display. So it displays, but here because I want to have same value for length, width, and height, what I can do here is I can modify the constructor in such a way that when I pass only length, then width and height will be set to length. Otherwise, whatever I pass, that should be used. So I'll modify the constructor here. I'll make W and H as default. W 0 and H 0. When I write this, then it will be default values. Length is always set to L is always set to length. Now if W is 0, if W equals to 0, then what I'll do is W 0, then I'll say both width and height as width, I'll set it to length. Similarly, I'll set height also to length if W is 0 or H is 0. So that is one way I can resolve this problem. So now what happens here? If I pass three parameters, three values will be set. One match. here. Next, not this. Width L self dot width. I'll say self because here we must set the values in if condition they'll not be set. So I'll make this W cell equals to height equals to zero. Now suppose if self dot width anything, I'll take this one self dot width is zero, then I'll set to L. So now I'll execute this. So when I pass the values, they are set. Now in this case, next case, what I'll do is I'll pass only length. Then remaining will be set to 10. So this is what I want. So 10, 10, 10. So it is set to 10. So this is one modification I am doing. So I am having a constructor with parameters. Earlier example, I gave here constructor with no parameter. This is constructor with no parameter. I'm not giving any values. I'm always setting it to some default values. Default values, which is lend, always it is set to 10, 7, 15. But here I'm building a constructor with the parameters, and also default arguments. Parameters and default arguments. Default values. So now this will allow me to send to set the length, width and height whatever I want, and also it is allowing us to set length, width and height to same value by passing only one parameter. So if I pass 10 here, then what happens here? W is 0 and H is 0 because I'm not passing. I'm setting LWH here, and if width is zero, that means surely height will also be zero. So I'll check only one. If width is zero, then width and height, I'm setting it to L. That's what I want. If width and height are not passed, I want the same, both width and height to be set to length. That's what I want. So that's what happened. This is one thing. Next thing is, so I'm calling a method called display. But generally we also in programming, we also print the object directly. Like I may print box one. So it is giving some, if I print the object directly, it is actually giving some information, which is actually hash code of the object. But generally this is not useful to the user. If the user prints the object directly, we have to give some meaningful information. So when any class object, is printed directly using print, actually what happens is it calls str method. Str is to convert it into string, str method. So to have str in the class, so if you want to print some meaningful information whenever the object is printed directly, so what you have to do to print meaningful information when object is printed, we have to define a function, a special function called a special function, which is underscore str underscore. This is the function we have to define. This is equals to calling this str function. So what I'll do is I'll modify this program now, the class, not program, class. So I'll add here the str underscore underscore str underscore, and any method must require self. I told you the purpose. So here what it has to do is it has to return some string, and I'll return a formatted string. Formatted string I can use f. Here what I'll do is I'll say length self dot length, then I'll give tab space, then I'll say width. Is it width? Okay, width self dot width, then height self dot height. So I'm whenever we print the object directly, so it calls the str function. Str function, if you want to implement in class, we have to define the function called underscore underscore str underscore underscore. Now if I execute this, if I execute this, and now I'll build the object again, this methods I'll take this one. And now I'll print directly box one. Now what is going to happen, you can see. Oh, is there all 9 7? So I'll exclude this. Some problem here. So init empty, executing. Where is that str? Oh, I have to keep this here. Sorry, I've kept in old. I've executed that, so that is the reason here. So what I'll do is I'll add here. I'll execute this. So I'll execute this again. Now I'll execute this. So I'll now it is giving length, width, height. So when I'm printing the object, now it is giving the information in some meaningful information. So whenever we want to have some meaningful information, when say I can always get like box one dot display, I can execute, but sometimes I may be printing the object directly. When I print the object directly, I should get some meaningful information. So that meaningful information I can get only when I define this method, define underscore underscore str. If I don't define this, then I'll get some hash code which is meaningless for me as a user of that class. So again, if I execute this, so I'm getting some information which is meaningless. So I'm getting some information which is meaningless for me. So if I want, always it is better to define str in each class, so which will return some meaningful information whenever object is printed directly. Whenever the object is printed directly, it returns some meaningful information. Here I'm just, I want to use space instead of tab. So I'll execute it again. So this is, so now if I execute here, I'll get some meaningful information. So I'm getting length 12, width 9, height 7 in one line. That is because of print object, not I'll remove this to avoid confusion. So when I print the object directly, I'm getting some meaningful information. So this is the importance of underscore underscore str underscore underscore. So whenever we actually what happens, even when I take this same underscore underscore str is called, now I'll will check when it is called. I'll keep a message there so that you will know when it is going to be called. So I'll say system dot out dot, sorry, I'm going to Java, print underscore underscore str is called. Just I'll keep that message. I'll execute this. So when I execute this, now that function is called. See, it is calling this. You can understand that it is called and it is also printed. Now, not only that. Suppose if I take box two, I'm constructing with the box with same value like 10. I'm constructing it. Now I'll apply a string. Some text, I want to get some string information or info about the object. What I'll do is I'll apply str function. So when I apply str function, also I'll get this underscore underscore str is called. So not only when you print the object, but also whenever you apply str function on any object, on the box object, underscore underscore str is called. Now if I print info, I'll get the information what is written by underscore underscore str. So if I print this, I'll get length 10, width 10, height 10. So here also str is function called, and here also it is called. In fact, whenever we print the object directly, it calls the str, it applies the str function. The str function calls the special the function with name underscore underscore str underscore underscores. That's why we are getting it. So it is always a good thing to have this function in every class, so that some meaningful information is returned whenever str function is applied on the object. So this is one concept I want to give. The next one is here. Now we'll go ahead with the constructor. Now if I take this here I am constructing with the three values given. So when I here I am constructing the object with three values given. That is one thing we are doing. Another thing what we are doing is with one value also we are constructing. With one value we are constructing. Now suppose I have length, width, height available in the form of. So I have length, width, height available in like this. Suppose I have 17, 12, 23, suppose 10. I have length, width, height available in this form, or I have length, width available in this form, like 13 comma 10 comma 9. I have length width available in list form. So here the data is available in string form. Now here data is available in list form. Now I want to build the object even when I have data in this form and I have data in this form. So how to build object? I require a constructor, but constructor here in Python is very limited because there is no overloading allowed. Suppose if overloading is allowed, then I can use the same function several times. One time I can pass series of integers, three integers. Second definition I can have only one integer. Third definition can take list. Fourth definition can take string. Like that I can have it, but Python does not allow overloading, so I can have only one kind of constructor, only one kind of constructor. Most the flexibility what you can have is we can have some flexibility with the help of default argument. So here what flexibility I'm getting with default argument is I'm now allowed to pass only one argument, which is actually set to all length, width and height. That means I want a box with same length, width and height. I need not pass it three times. I wanted to pass only one time. So that flexibility can be incorporated with the help of default arguments. But beyond that, if I want to have a different way of constructing, then it is not possible with the help of constructor. And there is a solution or alternate to this, which is called as factory methods. So even in Java there are factory methods are the methods which are used. They are not constructors, but they are used to build the construct the objects, or special methods other than constructors to build or to construct the objects. To build, that means construct the object. So they are generally called as factory methods. But in Python, the factory method is implemented. This is a general name. Now in Python, this factory method is called with a name called class method. So in Python, factory method is called with a name class method. So class method is a factory method. As the definition of factory method says, class method is a factory method. That means class method is used to construct the object, and it's a special method other than constructor to build the object. Now, whenever you want to have some special things to be incorporated in Python, so we use some decorators. So to build some special methods, decorators are used. We have several decorators to build this special method. Decorators are used. Now the decorator used to build class method is decorator used to build class method. All decorators, they begin with at the rate. So the decorator what we have to use with class method is at the rate class method. So the at the rate class method is a decorator which is used before the method, before the class method. Then when I use the decorator, it indicates that the subsequent method, whatever we are defining, is a class method, which is a factory method, and it is used to build the object. It is used to build the object. So that is one solution or alternate to overcome the limitation that is there in construction of objects in Python because of no support of overloading. So now I can have a decorator here. I want to build the box with a string. So I'll take the decorator at the rate class method. So this indicates that whatever I keep here is a class method. What class method does is it will build the object. So we can give whatever name we want, but if you take constructor, constructor is given always this name, but if it is a decorator, we can give any name. So if I take class method, I'll give a name called, because it's a method, but a special method. So I'll say box with string. I'll give the name. So here I'll be passing the string as parameter. So here one more thing with the class method is not only we have to use the decorator class method, we have to use a name CLS. Again, it's not a keyword. It is actually holding the name of the class for which we are going to build the object. Here in this case, CLS will be holding the name box. So here the information, whatever S box, the box information available in the form of a string, box information available in the form of a string. So I'll say str box. Now what I'll do is I'll take, now what the class method does is it will use that information input and convert into the form suitable for the constructor. So here I'm passing the data like this. Now this will be, so if I take this method here, the class method which I'm writing, so what that class method has to do is convert this information in the form suitable for constructor. That means 17, 12, 10, which is available as a string, should be separated into integer 17, integer 12, integer 10, suitable for constructor, and call the constructor. And call the constructor. With the name available as first parameter in class method. That means here there is a str box. Str box contains the string info, the box details in the form of a string. Convert that string into the form suitable for box like LWH, then use this name CLS to build the class. So here what I'll do is I'll take length, width and height, length L comma W comma H. Then I'll say str box split. So I'm splitting. Then I'll say return. I'm building the object using CLS. I can, I'll name here box. Then I'll return later. So box equals to CLS. CLS will be having the name of the class. CLS will have the name of the class. So I'll say L comma W comma H. Then I'll return that box. So this is how we do it. Now, if I execute this, If I I'll execute that just now what I have written here, class method. So I'll execute this. So I'll execute this. Now I'll build the object like this. So I'm building the object. So it is giving the information. I'll print the information. I'll get the information. Now I'll build the object in a different way. Box 3 equals to box suppose 17, 10, 20. Sorry. I'll say here, what I'll do here is, so here whenever we want to call that, so I have to take box dot box with string. So I have to write that one, box with string. Now I'll pass something like 17, 15, 10. So box 3 is built. Now if I print box 3, so print box 3, then that method is called. So it is giving the information. So length 17, 15, 10, it is actually calling this. So it is, I'll just keep a message there. So I'll say print, class method is called. So print class method. So I'll take str, I'll remove here. So I'll remove that message here to avoid confusion. Just I'll remove this message. So now if I execute this, not this. Yeah, this if I execute, I think I have to execute first this. So I'll execute this first. So it is executed. Then I'll execute this. So class method is called, then we are building the object with 17, 15, 10. So now the data is available in the string form and it is built with built with string. Now this method, I want to make it much better. Just for your understanding, I have written. So what I'll do is I'll directly send here. Is it okay? I'll try to modify this WH. Now I'll not store here, I'll directly return. So this I can improve. So I can say return instead of moving into box, I can do this way. I'll execute this again. I'll execute this again. So then again, I'll execute the same thing. So I'm getting the same result. Now, if possible, I'll further try to reduce here. What split can I? Yeah, I'll try to split. I'll try to use here, if possible, split. Okay, I'll try to execute this. I don't think it will work. We'll see what can be done for that. So here I'll execute this again. So it is creating a list is passed as parameter. So for all three, it is set because I'm using a single parameter. So then what I'll do here is it possible to keep asterisks here? Let's see whether it is possible or not. I have to check. So I'll execute this. So I think it should allow. Now I'll execute this. Now it is accepting. So what I am doing here is, so I am taking the string. So with one line, I am able to solve that problem. So I'm taking the string, converting, and also unpacking. This is important. When I don't unpack, then it will be sent as a list. When I unpack, it is sent as individual elements. It is sent as individual elements. So this is the improvement compared to the previous version. So in one line, I'm able to do that job. So I'm converting that string into a series of numbers which are available as list. Then list, if I pass directly, the list will be set as length, and because width and height we are not passing, only one parameter we are passing. So when width and height are zero, then width and height will be set to L. That's why we are getting two. So here you can observe what is happening if I don't give that unpacking there. So star unpacks the list. So here I'm using unpacking. If I don't use unpack, what is happening? You see that. So I'll execute this. Now when I execute this, because I am not unpacking, now 17, 15, 10 as a list, it will be sent, and one item, it will be sent as one item. When it is sent as one item, width and height will be taken default value 0 and 0. When width and height and 0 are 0, what we are doing here, as per our requirement, so now only one item is coming. So width is 0. Width is set to length and width height is set to length. Length is a list, so that is the problem we are getting. So now you can observe here what happens when I don't unpack. See, length is set as list 17, 15, 10 because it is passed as one argument. Width is set as a list, and also the height is set as a list. And one more thing here is now if I take this. One more problem is there, but it is working fine, but there is one problem. You will understand that problem. Now what I'll do is I want to calculate area and volume for this class, for box class. I want to calculate area and volume. So what I can do is I'll keep area and the two methods here. I'll keep two methods, area and volume. Define cal area. Say cal area self. So what I'll do here is self dot area equals to self dot length. Self dot width. So that is what we want. I'll also return here. I'll also return the test. At this stage, I'll keep only area. Later, we'll see the other things. So I'll say area self dot area. Now. We'll see what is going to happen. So I'll execute this. So it is the class is executed fine. Now I'll execute this one. I'll get fine. So some error, maybe area, it is maybe giving error. Box object has no attribute area. Okay, sorry, here I should have called cal area. That is one important thing. Then only it is set here, cal area. Should call. I think I have to call with self dot call area. Now I think it works fine. We'll see. Now I'll execute this again. I think it is working fine. Now it is also giving area, so it is working fine. So it is working fine because here I'm constructing. While I construct, I'm calling area. So I want to have an area. Area, I'll take it as length and width. So area is calculated and it is kept. Now, if I build it with a string, so here, if I build it with a string, now I'll in the class method, I'll unpack so that problem will not come. But it looks it works fine, but it has one small problem. You'll understand now. So you are getting a problem. The problem is the length and width, they are set as integers. The length and width here, not I have to execute this. So if I execute this now, so here this is set as length width count multiplies sequence of non-int of type list. So have a return split. Yeah, it is split. So now so what here we are getting problem is they are actually they are available as strings. So I had to do some modification to this. The modification what I can do here is here split, I'll apply map list map int. I have to convert them into int. So this is what we want. So this is, then I'll give one bracket for this, one bracket for this. Now we'll see what is going to happen. Execute this. Now execute this. Now we are getting correctly. So that is the problem. So because earlier we did not do any kind of arithmetic operation, so it was looking fine, but length and width were set as strings. So that is why we were getting the problem. So what I am doing, I'm splitting, converting into integer, which will give the list. That list I am unpacking. So there are so many things are happening here. The string is split into a series of words, and those words are converted into integers, and that integer will be available as list. Integer list is available that I'm unpacking. So when I unpack, I'll get a series of length, width, and height. So that's what happening there. So that is a box with a string. Now, if I want to build the box with list, so I can define one more here, class method and box list means data is available as list. So LST box. LST box. So here I'll say return directly. I'll write CLS. Simply I'll what I'll do is I'll unpack. I think this should work fine. I'll unpack, I'm sending, so it should work fine. So I've built the class again. Now this should work fine as it is. Now I'll create one more here, box 4. Box 4 equals to box with list. So what I'll do is I'll take a list here, LST box, and I'll make equals to something like 15 comma 9 comma 7. Now I'll pass this LST box. Then I'll print that box 4, print. Now I should get correctly. Everything should be fine. We'll see what is going to happen. So I'll execute this. I think it gives correct result. So it is giving correct result. So 15, 9, 135. So it is giving correct result. So that is how we actually can overcome the problem of limitation in the constructor. Overcome the problem of limitation in the constructor. So this is we have incorporated so many features within this class. Now if I go through class once here. So I have a class box here. I have a constructor which takes 3 parameters and 2 are default arguments, and only width and height are not passed. That means I want both width and height set to length. So the logic is to do that. If 3 are passed, 3 are considered. If only 1 is passed, all the 3 are set to the same value, first value. And we have also added calculate area. This has actually this particular thing has revealed one mistake. Otherwise it is difficult to find that mistake, that is data remaining as a string. So because I have kept cal area there, so the length, width and height, suppose if I pass it as string, it will not accept. Then I have a display method to display it, but this is the constructor which allows us to build the object using 3s integers. Now if I want to build the box from the data which is available in a different form like string, so if it is available in string form, in other form what we have to do is we have to use the class methods. Class methods, what they do is they are not building the object on their own. The class method will be used to convert the data in the form suitable to the constructor. Then we are calling the constructor. The class name is available here in the first parameter. Again, I can give any name here, there. I can give any name like class name or C name. I can give any name. It is not matter. It is not necessary that we should have CLS. I can give any name. So string box, the string, the box data available in string form, I'm converting into the form suitable for the constructor. So what I'm doing to do that, I'm splitting the data into series of words. Then each word is converted into integer with map, and that after conversion, it is available as list. But this requires the data as series of integers. So I'm unpacking and I'm calling the constructor. Then I'm building the object. So if the data is available as a string list, then the data is available as list. I'm just unpacking and calling the constructor. Then this is for displaying the data in suitable form, in meaningful form, when the object is printed directly. So that's what I'm using there. Then I'm having one method, cal area. So I have incorporated so many facilities in this class, so many facilities, and we have discussed several concepts in this class. So in the box class, I can also suppose I can have a different information like I may have the data in file also. I may have data in file, and it may be. So here I'll take one more example where it will take the data from the file. So if the file is available, it will take the data from the file. We'll see that, and I'll do it using IDLE because we require local file. So what I'll do here is I'll open IDLE. I'll create a class. Here I want to have I want to have some class called data. So in this I want to have a constructor which is available. So I'll define a constructor which is underscore underscore init underscore. So self is compulsory, then the data is available as suppose list. And even it is stored as list within the class. So that is item. Suppose if it is stored as list, I am copying that. If it is available as list, it is okay. Directly I can store. Now, if it is available as a string, so what I can do, I can go for a class method. Class method. Then I can define here just and the method. So data, suppose with string. So data with string. So here class name, then the item data, str items, item data available as string. So this is I have. So what I'll do is I'll say return class. So str items, str items split, and again it is split into words. So I'll do it with the map. I'll map it with the map function, convert everything into integer, then I'll send the list. So this is when it is available in string form, it will be converted and sent. Now, what I'll do is I'll take one function here, just one this str function. Which what it does is it will give the data as a string, just so return. What I'll do is. I have to return. Okay, I'll just return join items. So we'll see. This is I'll add more facilities. So this class I have now. I'll take. Data data one. I'll say data. I'll pass the list. So LST data. I'll take something like 10, 20, 30, 40. That is available. So I'll take data LST data. So it should work fine. Now I'll execute this. I'll print this. So when I say print data one, so I'll execute this. So this is what I'll say data class data. I'll say CLS data. LST data is not defined. Sorry, there I have used some capital letter, so that I should not have used, or I'll make this capital letter. So that is the problem. So I'll execute it. items is not defined. Items here, self dot items, we have to say self dot items. Okay, it is available as strings. So what I have to do is okay, then I have to take map. Do I'm doing the reverse of that. So I'll execute. So now it is available. I'm getting the output. Now suppose if the data is available as string, next thing is, so LST string. Now data is available as string, like 5, 8, 23, 64, 29, 100. Suppose if data is available as string, so now I can build the object data2 equals to data dot data with string. I am building it, so I'll pass lst str str. Now then I'll say print data. So now that is available as it is converted into items. Then when it is printed, it is printed back as string. Now I'll execute this. It should it will work fine. So I'm getting it. Now one more way here is, suppose if the data is available as a file, data is available as file. Now when data is available as file, so what, suppose here I'll take one notepad file where it is stored, python cls data python 39. Okay. I'll create a file there, create notepad file. I have data available in file 10, 20, 11, 22, 33, 44, 55, 60, 30, 40, 50. Suppose if the data is available in the form of a file, I'll save this. So where I'll save is, I'll take this path, whatever I have, I'll take this path, I'll save there. I'll take in this, I'll take something like sample.txt, sample data.txt. So it is available as sample data.txt. So now this data, I'll get it into file. So what I'll do is, I want to build the class object with from data available from file. So what I'll do is, I'll create one more class method, which is so define data with file, data from file, suppose from file. So class as it is, and the file name we have to take. Now what we'll do here is, that file name will open for reading purpose. So we'll say fread open file name for reading purpose. Okay, file name for reading purpose. Now I'll read that. Now I'll read that string data. So I'll say string lst str. Now I'll read it once. So fr dot read. then because there is already we have a constructor, I need not do again that job. So what I'll do is I'll say return data. I'll call that method string data with string lst. Yeah. So this is a better way. So now if I execute this, so I'll take here data 3 equals to data with from file. So what is the file name? So pass the file name sample data dot txt. Now I'll print that data 3. So I'll execute this. So we are getting the data from file. It is converted into this and we are getting the data. So the limitation of the constructor can be overcome with the class methods. So I am building the object from string. I am building the object from file. So when it is file, I am reading and getting the data into string. Instead of repeating this step, what I am doing is I'm calling this and getting the data in list. So that is what happening here. So we can have some flexibility there with the help of class methods and class methods.